Morning and welcome to this video in See the Light, Easy Wins to Improve Your Asset Framework Experience. So we've done four out of the six issues that the engineer found for us. The first one being that if FS05 wasn't available in PyVersion, he fixed that by applying a template to the unit. The second issue was that the sugar grain size was duplicated for units 3, 4, and 6. This is a common symptom when people use allow extensions. So what we did is we disallowed extensions and then we used what is called a derived template to take care of the difference between the salt and the sugar units. The third issue we fixed was that the sealer temperature was way out of bounds on the form fill and seal machines. That is because the units had been purchased in Europe and we're measuring in degrees Celsius. We are displaying in Fahrenheit. So we just needed to make sure that we double specified our units of measure in asset framework so that it knew that it could it needed to do the conversion. And then the fourth issue is a biggie. It saved a lot of time for a lot of people because we stopped referencing a 300,000 row table and moved it down to only return the data for the specific units that we queried. That was done through parameterized queries. Now, the fifth issue the engineer pointed out to us was that in PyVersion, when he was looking at the detailed display for the form fill and seal machines, he noticed that on form fill and seal unit number 4, there was a problem where the nominal max throughput wasn't being displayed. This is luckily only an issue on unit number 4. It works for the others. So what we're going to do is, again, configuration changes don't work in PyVersion. We'll switch across to PySystem Explorer. And I've got Form Fill and Seal Machine 4 loaded up here. To see how the nominal max throughput value gets its data, we can click on it and have a look at the settings field on the right-hand side. In our case, this is a table lookup. And our settings are we want to select the max throughput from the table called model specifications, where the model value in the table is matching the value of the model in our attributes. So we want the model in the table to match our model, which in our case is MF Techno. This seems like there should be no problems. It's working for unit number 6. So what we'll go ahead and do is open up our library and just inspect the table for model specifications. You can see we've got the three entries, the ADCON MF Techno, and then the big box entry that I made in our previous exercise. What I've put up in front of you is a comparison between units FFS04 and the table. And if we have a look, the error is pretty clear to see what the problem is, where we've got ADCO is 75 and MF Techno is 70. However, FFS04 is spelled MF space TECHNO, and there is no H in our model table. Now, there are two ways to fix this. The first way would be for me to go to my elements, and because model has got a data reference of none, I can simply come in here and delete the H. If I refresh, fantastic, problem solved. We can go back to working. You are relying on a human to spell correctly. And if I've learned anything, it's that the more you can take the possibility of a human making a mistake away from your system, the less likely it is that there will be mistakes in the system. So what we want to do, instead of having the person type in the name of the model, we want to make it so that they can select from a dropdown. That is possible in Asset Framework using what are called enumeration sets. Enumeration sets are found in our library. And if you are familiar with the PyData Archive, if you've worked with PyData Archive for a while, this can be sort of analogous to what is called a digital set in PyAF. What we're doing here is every time the system sends a value of 0 or 1, we will convert it into MF Techno or ADCO. What we can also do is in our element templates, for sandbox FFS. I can go up to my attributes, select the model, and instead of using a value type of string, we're going to say I only want values that come from the model list enumeration set. If I select that and check in my change, when I go through to my elements, you'll see that model is blank for FFS04 and 1 and 2. That's the problem with applying a digital set after the fact. It will wipe the results that have been written in there. So what we're going to do is go and fill out this form according to the table that is on screen at the bottom. So unit 1 is ADCO. ADCO. 3 is ADCO. 4 is MF Techno. 5 is ADCO. Now, if this is taking a long time, and 6 is MF Techno. If you're worried that this takes a long time, it is possible to do all of this through Power Builder in Microsoft Excel. For 6 units, it's not worth opening up Excel and going through the process, but if you had 100 units, you're definitely going to want to have to do that. What we will do is check in our change. Now, when I go back to my PowerVision display, I can see that for FFS04, we've got the correct model now, MF Techno spelled correctly, which gives us the nominal max throughput. And also go to FFS01. And FFS03, and they seem to be working. Now, the best practice we've applied here is that it's always a good idea to remove the potential for human error. So by applying a enumeration set and letting the engineer choose the asset rather than type it in, we've saved ourselves some potential headaches in future. The next is going to be the last of our 6 issues, and that's just fixing a title in PowerVision and making sure that it changes according to the asset that we have selected.